Good morning, students. Today we will discuss the chapter 6, Elasticity of Demand. Okay. So already we have studied this chapter. Today we are going to revision of this chapter. Okay. So the topics in this chapter are concept of elasticity of demand, then meaning of price elasticity of demand, then measurement, that how we measure the elasticity of demand, then different situation of elasticity of demand, then factor affecting price elasticity of demand. Okay, if you recall, we discussed the law of demand chapter. In that we discussed that law of demand state that whenever there is increase in the price of the commodity, there is increase, decrease in the quantity demanded. Means law of demand state that there is inverse relation. When price of the commodity increase, quantity demanded decrease, and price decrease, quantity demanded increase. So what this shows, that there is inverse relation between price and quantity demanded. Okay, so by law of demand we came to know that in which direction demand change due to change in the price of the commodity. Okay, so elasticity of demand, elasticity tell us about that what extent there is change in the quantity demanded. Okay, law of demand only tell about the direction, but elasticity of demand tell us about that what extent there is change in the quantity demanded. So concept of elasticity of demand means that what is elasticity of demand? Elasticity of demand measure the responsiveness change in quantity demanded due to change in own price of the commodity. Over price of the commodity. What it means? Elasticity of demand measure the responsiveness change in quantity demanded due to change in own price of the commodity. It means that it tells about elasticity of demand tell us that at what extent there is change in quantity demanded due to change in the price of the commodity. Okay. Then we discuss about the price elasticity of demand. Okay, in price elasticity of demand we discuss that change in quantity demanded due to change in price of the commodity. Price of the commodity means what extent change is there in quantity demanded due to change in the price of the commodity. Okay, so we will discuss the three types of elasticity of demand: price elasticity of demand, income elasticity of demand. First is price elasticity, then income elasticity, income elasticity of demand, then cross price elasticity of demand. Cross price elasticity of demand. Okay, so first price elasticity of demand means change in quantity demanded due to change in price of the commodity. Then income elasticity of demand, change in quantity demanded due to change in income of the consumer. Okay, means what change is there in quantity demanded due to change in the income of the person. Third, cross price elasticity means change in price of what commodity. For example, change in price of X, what effect changes there on quantity demanded good Y. Okay, means cross price we discuss about two goods, that is substitute and complementary goods. For example, tea and coffee are substitute goods. Tea and coffee are substitute goods. So increase in the price of tea, what effect what effect on the quantity demanded of other commodity, that is gross price elasticity of demand. Okay, so we have discussed the three type of elasticity, that is price, income and cross. Next is measurement. How we measure the elasticity of demand? We are saying that elasticity of demand tell us about the change in quantity demanded due to change in price of the commodity, that what extent change is there, how we will measure that. Okay, measurement, that how we measure the elasticity of demand. So mostly percentage method is used to measure the elasticity of demand. Okay, so formula of calculating elasticity of demand is change in percentage change in quantity demanded upon percentage change in price. Okay, we can also write this formula like change in quantity upon initial quantity, change in price upon initial price into 100. Okay, then we get change in Q upon Q, change in P upon P. We can also write this P upon Q into change in Q upon change in P. Okay, P upon Q into change in Q upon change in P. Okay, so this is the formula of calculating elasticity of demand. We will do a numerical by using this formula. Like we have given P means price is equal to 4. P1, change in price is 2. Initially price is 4 and when price change means decrease, then it become 2. And quantity is 1. When price is 4, then quantity demanded is 1, means initial quantity is 1. Then change in quantity demanded due to price is 4. Okay, so we will use the formula P upon Q, means P initial P we have given 4, Q we have given 1 into change in Q. Change in Q, how we will calculate change in Q? Change in Q we will calculate Q 1 minus Q, means whatever quantity is demanded after change in price minus initial quantity. So we have given 4 minus 1 equal to 3. Okay, then change in Q is 3. Then change in P, how we will calculate change in P? P1 minus P. Okay, P1 we have given 2, means initially P is 4 and change in P is 2. So 4 minus 2 we have 2. Okay, as we always use negative sign in front of formula because law of demand says that there is inverse relation between price and quantity demanded. Okay, so we will use the negative sign 2. Okay, here we get minus 6 and means there is negative relation and 2 and 3 already minus. So we got 6. What this 6 shows, that 6 is greater than 1. It means elasticity of demand is greater. Elasticity of demand is greater. What it means? It means that due to change in price, there is more change in quantity demanded. Okay, when price becomes 2 from 4, okay, then quantity demanded increase from 1 to 4. Means quantity demanded change more compared to change in price. Okay, so this is our last measurement of elasticity of demand. The next is different situation of elasticity of demand. Different situation of elasticity of demand. In this we will discuss when ED means elasticity of demand is equal to infinite, then elasticity of demand is equal to 0 and elasticity of demand is equal to equal to 1. We will discuss these three different situations with the help of diagram. So here we have given on OX is quantity demanded and on OYX is price of the commodity. Okay. So first is AD is infinite. It is horizontal. Okay. This is our P and it is also demand. Okay. So it is our price. Okay. So the quantity demanded is infinite on this price. For example, P is equal to 5. If there is slight change in price, then quantity demanded becomes 0. Okay. This is our elasticity of demand is here infinite because due to slightly changing price, there is unlimited change in quantity demanded. Okay. So this is called perfectly elastic demand. Perfectly elastic demand. Elastic demand is due to change in price, there is elastic change. Perfectly elastic means the quantity demand is flexible, it changes with the change in price. This next is AD equal to 0. Elasticity of demand is equal to 0. On OY axis we will take quantity demanded and on OY axis we will take price. So this is our quantity demanded D, this is our demand curve, and whatever price that does not matter, 2, 4, 6, 8, our quantity demanded remain fixed. Okay, so here elasticity of demand is perfectly inelastic. Perfectly inelastic. Okay, it is AD is equal to 0. Whatever the change in price, that does not affect the quantity demanded. For example, change in price of salt, that does not affect quantity demanded because this is our initial demand. We will obviously purchase salt, matchboxes, all small these things are toothpaste. Whatever the price change, obviously we will purchase. Okay. So the elasticity of demand for these goods is perfectly inelastic and AD is equal to 0. The next is AD is equal to 1. On O-axis we will take quantity demanded. On OY-axis we will take price. And our demand curve is rectangular hyperbola. Okay. On this, whatever change in price, there is change in quantity demanded. And we can say this is measured with the help of total expenditure method. Okay. Total expenditure method. Due to change in price of the commodity, our total expenditure change. Okay. So on this demand curve, AD is equal to 1. Okay. This demand curve shape is rectangular hyperbola, and on this old demand curve DD, the elasticity of demand is equal to 1, or we can say unity. Okay. Whatever the change in price, there is change in quantity demanded. Okay. Because if price decreasing, then also we purchasing goods, so our total expenditure remain the same on the quantity demanded, that does not change. Whatever the price change, that does not affect our total expenditure. Our total expenditure remains same. Okay, so this is rectangular hyperbola and AD is equal to 1. The next is factor affecting price elasticity of. So factor affecting elasticity of demand, the first is nature of the commodity. As nature of the commodity affect the elasticity of demand. For example, the goods like necessity of our life, Colgate, brush, salt, all these have inelastic demand. Okay, but the goods which like refrigerator, air conditioner, furniture, all these have elastic demand because due to increasing the price of air conditioner, we can postpone the purchasing. Okay, we will think that we will purchase next time, we can postpone this air conditioner because price is high, but we cannot postpone the essential things, means the necessity of life. Okay, so the elasticity of demand also depends on the nature of the commodity, that what type of commodity we are purchasing. The next is availability of goods. Availability of goods means the goods which have close substitute have elastic demand. Okay, elastic, close substitute means, for example, tea and coffee have close substitute. If price of the tea increase, then the demand for coffee will increase. So this is elastic demand, because people can shift their demand from one good to other good. But if there is no substitute of good like cigarette, then we can say liquid, then the people cannot shift their demand, because they are habitual of that thing, so they obviously they will purchase. Then multiple use, if a good have multiple use, then the elasticity of demand is elastic. For example, milk. Okay, milk we use for many purpose, like for drinking, making tea, curd. If price of milk increase, then we can restrict our use. Okay, we will use only for drinking, or we can say we will use only to make tea. So the demand which have multiple uses can have elasticity of demand is elastic, but the goods which do not have multiple use is inelastic demand. Okay, then postponement of use means the same thing. The goods which are luxury, we can postpone the purchasing, like car, air conditioner, all these we can postpone the purchase. But the goods which cannot be postponed have inelastic demand. Income level, if the person is having higher level of income, then elasticity of demand is high. If the income is low, then the elasticity of demand is low, means inelastic. Then habit of consumer, if a consumer is habitual of eating a commodity, or we can say he is having habit of taking cigarette, means we can say, then the person will purchase whatever the price, that will not affect the habit of the consumer. So the price elasticity of demand is inelastic in case of habit of the consumer. Then time period, if there is long time period, then the goods can be shifted. Okay, so there is elasticity of demand. If time period is short, then there is inelastic demand, means elasticity of demand is inelastic. Then price level, high price of commodity have more elasticity because they can be shifted. For example, high price like jewelry, if there is high price of diamond, or we can say gold, then we can postpone our purchasing. Okay, and low price commodity, for example, small things like matchboxes, salt, all these have small prices, so these have inelastic demand, or we can say less demand. Okay, so these are the factors that affect the elasticity of demand. Okay, so student, this is our chapter that we have discussed the concept of elasticity, the meaning, then type, income elasticity, price elasticity, cross elasticity. Then measurement, percentage method is the most common used method to measure the price elasticity of demand. Then different situation, inelastic, elastic, and AD is equal to 1. Then factor affecting elasticity of demand. Okay, so watch the video, also revise from your book. If you have any doubt, any query, you are free to ask. Practice as the diagram on your notebook. Okay, thank you, students.